So, myopic traction maculopathy is a known term with the advent of new OCT, high dimension OCT machine. So, the foveal sclerosing tractional maculopathy, the pathogenesis is actually anteroposterior traction by the posterior hyoid and epiretinal membrane over the retina, and the horizontal tangential traction by the retinal vascular small blood vessels, the rigid ILM, and lastly the posterior staphyloma, which give rise to this kind of problem in myopic patient. So big eye with big problem. So what the myopic traction maculopathy can leads to? It can leads to foveal sclerosis, lamellar macular hole, full thickness macular hole, subretinal fluid, and lastly the retinal detachment. So it has staged in following staging. It is recently published in European Journal in Ophthalmology by Barbara et al. In 2020. It has tangential evaluation and perpendicular evaluation. If you see the tangential evaluation, it stages from the normal retina to lamellar macular hole, the full thickness macular hole, and perpendicular progression varies from foveal sclerosis, subfoveal fluid, and total retinal detachment along with the macular hole. So treatment option of myopic traction maculopathy, it can resolve by its own, or if it doesn't resolve, if it progress, we have to opt for vitrectomy with ILM peeling or macular buckling or suprachoroidal buckling. Now, what is the indication of surgery in myopic traction maculopathy? If there is a foveal detachment, first indication. If there is a full thickness macular hole, if there is a macular hole related retinal detachment in myopic patient, if there is a foveal sclerosis with gradual loss of vision. So what is the difficulty of myopic macular hole and sclerosis? The difficulty is the myopia, the length of the eyeball. It's very difficult to approach to the posterior pole due to the longness of the eyeball. And abnormally thin retina, choroidal atrophy give rise very difficult view of the ILM, and very difficult to peel the ILM. And ILM is very sticky, is very strongly adherent to the retinal underlying structure. So it often comes out in bits and pieces rather than coming as a whole. And sometimes ILM peeling we give rise to iatrogenic retinal break formation in myopic patient. So the outcome of idiopathic macular hole is more successful. It's around 90%, but in myopic macular hole, the success rate comes down to 60 to 90%. It varies from person to person. So surgical tips, we have to make the sclerotomies wide apart. So in order to reach the posterior pole easily, and we have to stain the vitreous with triamcinolone acetonide multiple times. Use of the forceps or silicon tip flute cannula in order to induce the posterior vitreous detachment. Brilliant blue green dye should be used multiple times in order to visualize the ILM, because it is not visible well even with the single staining technique. Foveal sparing ILM peeling and myopic was useful in myopic foveal sclerosis with foveal detachment, and ILM tugging often beneficial in myopic macular hole. Wide dissection of ILM is necessary up to at least 2 degrees diameter, and gas tamponade often gives better result compared to the silicone oil. Now, inverted ILM flap often gives better result than the conventional peeling, because ILM acts as a scaffold for the cellular proliferation and gliosis and photoreceptor realignment. Now, to keep the inverted flap in position, we can use the viscoelastic material, perfluorocarbon, or lower the intraocular pressure by decreasing the bottle height, or in constellation, reduce the millimeter of mercury pressure in fluid. Now, there are certain literature which often shows that there is a better outcome with the inverted flap technique rather than conventional ILM peeling. Now, other than ILM peeling, other techniques to close the macular hole in myopic patient, is the anterior posterior, the anterior or posterior lens capsule can be planted in the macular hole, or ILM can be free flap can be used to plug in the macular hole. The retinal free flap, retinal tissue taken up from the other side, can be put inside the macular hole or amniotic membrane grafting. Now, sometimes we often fail to close the macular hole in a myopic patient. In these cases, the autologous retinal flap is often useful. And the next topic, other than macular hole, is the myopic macular hole retinal detachment. The SCIESIS often leads to the progression of retinal detachment in myopic patient. This is an example of a patient of 45-year-old male with a myopic macular hole with a large foveal detachment. If you can see, there is an area of foveal detachment at the center, and there is a myopic degeneration. So we started with the vitrectomy. If you have the PVD already there, you are very lucky, because myopic patient doesn't have posterior vitreous detachment. So we have to stain the posterior vitreous with the triamcinolone. So I'm using the silicone tip flute needle in order to make a cleavage in the posterior hyoid phase, not to induce the posterior vitreous detachment. So it multiple strokes all around away from the foveal area. So this is how I have succeeded in the PVD. Now I am using cutter to remove the posterior hyoid. Now using the BBG dye to stain the ILM. Now ILM is stained. Now I'm using here the contact lens system in order to visualize the ILM clearly. There's a central macular hole. This is a conventional ILM peeling technique. So I'm peeling the ILM, and peeling ILM at least 2 degrees diameter away from the macular hole as far as possible in order to get a better result. So it's almost done. So peeling of ILM around more than 2 degrees diameter. So now I'm doing fluid air exchange, and ultimately C3 gas tamponade was given. So this is the post-operative outcome. 6 weeks, vision improved from counting finger to 3/60, but you can see there is a thinning of the fovea. So often you succeed to close the macular hole, even though the visual outcome is not good. Now, ILM repositioning with autologous blood is another technique where you can go with this kind of cases with a macular hole with myopia with a relatively good result. And lastly, the option is the macular buckle. The indication of macular buckle is very high myopia with extensive chorioretinal atrophy with posterior staphyloma, and failed vitrectomy with the primary surgery. And if there is a posterior staphyloma, very difficult to approach the posterior pole, then we can opt for macular buckling. But it has a lot of complications like orbital fat prolapse, injury to the vortex, injury to the ciliary vessel, perforation, submacular hemorrhage, and even it can be misplaced in the different quadrant. So it needs certain degree of expertise to give a better result. There is a learning curve in macular buckle surgery. So to conclude, macular hole in myopia is it's a very difficult case. It is a threat to the retinal surgeon. And is the guide, SDOCT will help us to show whether you have retinal detachment along with the hole or not. Inverse flat often gives a better result. Axial length more than 30, it carries the poor prognosis. A neurosensory graft Often the free retinal flap can be used to in cases of failed macular hole in myopia.